Welcome back everyone for an episode of Tips, a new shorter and focused format that brings you super useful tips to master your tools. And this time, I'm giving you 4 power tips to get that text per generator on steroids. Let's get started. This video is very much an extension of our text versus text plus tutorial. And as it was packed with useful information, I recommend that you watch it if you haven't already. Advanced image mapping, or the ability to fill up a text with an image. In our introduction video, we showed you how you could do this right from the edit page by going to the shading panel, change type to image, choose clip, and browse to choose an image. That's great, but once inside Fusion, you can also use tool as image source and connect, for example, a loader to that new input, which means that you have complete control over that image and you can add any kind of transformation or effect to it. I'm going to switch mapping level to full image and add a transform node so I can adjust the image position. Little bonus for when you want to animate text and content simultaneously. As scaling your text doesn't affect the image inside, you might think about simply using a transform node downstream. This can work, but as this text node is outputting at 1920 by 1080, resizing will degrade the definition, even if you start with a large text. And rather than upscaling the text node resolution, which would seriously impact performance, why not be smart? We can add expressions to both mapping size and mapping angle, and connect them to controls inside the layout panel. Mapping size to size, and mapping angle to the Z-axis rotation. Done. Whenever I resize my text, the image is now remapped automatically while still outputting at 1920 by 1080. And if you want a video to play inside the text, simply connect a media in or an image sequence to that input. Text control and custom kerning inside the viewer. When the text plus node is selected, you will find a series of buttons at the top left of the viewer. The first button allows you to type text directly inside the preview window. I'm not sure why you would do this, but it is an option. The next one is a lot more useful, as once selected, you can move individually any character for custom styling. Because the characters are not dynamically rendered while moving, it can be pretty difficult to be precise. But this is where the last button will come really handy. Once activated, it displays an outline around the text that, you guessed it, is visible when you use manual positioning. This option is also super handy when a text has its transparency set to 0, or is out of frame. You can even choose the outline to be only visible outside of the frame by clicking on the second button or hide it completely with the first one. Modifiers. Modifiers are like giving superpowers to your tools, and with the text plus generator, you can do some really cool stuff. Right-click inside the text input field and choose text timer, for example. This unlocks the modifier panel where you can choose between countdown, timer, and clock. Clock is super useful when you need to export several frames watermarked with the current date. But you could also automatically time how long it takes you to build something by adding a timer overlay. Another great option is timecode, that you can use to create a stylized and customizable timecode generator that can then be placed and scaled anywhere on the timeline. Placing and animating a text on the path. Go to the layout panel, switch type to path, and trace a polyline inside the viewer for the text to follow. You can use all the usual buttons to customize the polyline, and the following controls inside the inspector will let you position the text on the path. If you want to quickly and precisely create a shape for the text to follow, right-click on the text, choose path, create, and either choose ellipse or rectangle. Set the size, and if the text will be applied clockwise or counterclockwise. To easily resize or position this rectangle, I can click select all points and shape box. Then, to animate the text along the path, I can simply adjust the position on path control and add keyframes. All right, this is it. If you enjoyed this new format, please let us know in the comment and we'll see you in the next video. See ya.
Right, this is it. If you enjoyed this new format, let us know in the comment and we'll see you in the next video. Oh yeah.